Hello everybody and welcome to Luxury Benefits channel. My name is Sviatoslav and in this video we will talk about central fixation and movement, about the anatomy and structure of the eye, what is interfering with the scanning process and why do we need the rest of the retina. Fixation and movement are the key to excellent vision. The next technique for natural restoration of vision is called central fixation. This is perhaps the most difficult to learn method of removing mental and physical stress, which Bates himself puts in first place in his program. From his word, it's clear that the ability to central fixation is of prime importance for normal vision. But from the way Bates described the ways and means of restoring this fixation, it is so difficult to understand anything in it. At least I couldn't do it. When I first got it in my hands for the opportunity to get rid of glasses, I was convinced by Bates' opinion about causes of visual impairment. His words about the dangers of wearing glasses and the importance of stress relief. However, how only I got to the topic central fixation, the enthusiasm to engage my vision completely evaporated. I realized that it's important for eye, but didn't understand how to restore this fixation. The book was abandoned for many years until I got to a training to get rid of eyeglasses, which is stimulated my desire to help people in a similar way. But I also didn't understand the essence of the central fixation from his lectures, and without this it was pointless start teaching and maintain your visual activity. As a result, I myself had to cover with books and having studied various sources to finally understand this most important component of our vision. The central fixation is so hard to understand because it seems that few people really imagine the process of visual perception. So let's start with a short description of this mechanism. Central fixation secrets. It is known that all rays from a perceived object are focused on the back surface of the eyeball, called retina or reticular shell. It is the thinnest, most difficult, and most psychologically an important part of the eyeball, which is the beginning of the visual analyzer. It is peripheral department. The structure of the eye. Having the most complex structure of 10 layers, the retina tissue in the center become thinner to one layer, forming a small depression, the central hole. Inside it, the thinnest layer of the retina and the center of the most acute vision, called a macula. That's what is the central vision, since here is the place of maximum the sensitivity of the eyes, which is responsible for the clarity of the image. Thus, central fixation is the ability of the eyes to see most clearly when we are looking at directly, not what is around. Why in reality do we not feel this, but see the object is equally clear or equally blurry? Why when looking at a person doesn't seem to me that I can see his nose more clearly, for example, and less clear cheeks? To understand this, it is necessary to remember that the main law of vision is movement. More precisely, the movement of retinal nerve cells at a speed of 100 and more times per second. What is interfering with the scanning process? Instant scanning is difficult due to eye strain. Overload occurs due to excessive using the eyes without rest or after any negative emotions. It leads to a violation of the accommodative ability of the eyes to focus rays through the lens directly onto a central part of the retina, and the sensitivity of the fovea itself is reduced to such an extent that the eyes begin to see better with other parts of the retina located in the central fovea. A person detects this when he tries to see an object from the side or upper vision or narrows his eyes too much, and it seems to him that he sees it better. In the future, he began to use this eye manipulation and already consciously that out of habit, which leads to eccentric fixation, according to Dr. Bates. It is unnatural for the eyes and leads to various anomalies or refraction, to an even greater tension of the visual mechanism, because deprives him of a relaxed state and the possibility of involuntary vibrations at the level of the retinal nerve tissue. Consequently, the cycle activity itself depends on the degree relaxation of the eyes, mental and human body. According to Bates, the main reason for the loss of central fixation, mental and physical stress. And since all abnormal conditions of the eyes are accompanied by one kind or another tension, absolutely everyone needs to restore it. After all, when the brain is tense, eyes are more or less blind. And first of all, the visual center weakens. When the eyes are capable of central fixation, they have not only perfect vision, but also are in ideal state of rest and can be used for a long time without fatigue. Surely many have noticed how some people squint when trying to see something in the distance or make out the fine print. They don't want to wear glasses, but their eyes can no longer deal with their task. Often these people don't even notice that they're squinting, it has become a habit with them. But this is abnormal to the eyes and is fraught with astigmatism. The second major cause of loss of ability to central fixation is the wearing of glasses, and especially the incorrect selection according to the distance between the centers. Think about what has happened in the ophthalmologist's office. He puts diagnosis and then selects lenses of appropriate diopters for the right and left eye. Having written these numbers in the prescription, the doctor makes another measurement and also indicates it in the receipt. When I ask people what the doctor measures, I most often answer that the distance between the pupil. Yes, this is how it looks from the outside. In fact, the doctor is interested in distance between the visual centers, macula on the retina of our eyes. By setting the center-to-center distance for lenses in size between pupils, the doctor may well admit an error, since the center pupils and macular centers are not at the same level. And if the center of the lens doesn't correspond to the visual center, then the formation of a false macula occurs somewhere on the lateral, lower or upper areas of the retina. If in addition lenses are incorrectly centered in optics, a person putting on glasses feels dizziness, nausea, pain and sore eyes. The same feeling experienced by a person who uses other people's glasses. This is often the case in older families. Eventually, the discomfort goes away because the person gets used to inconvenient frame but only due to the formation of a false, the visual center on the lateral parts of the retina. As a result, when a person takes off his glasses, the surrounding object is blurred or bifurcated. Sometimes the eyes see several images. This happens in cases of a frequent change of glasses, with different the shape and size of frames, as well as when buying them without a doctor's prescription. Why do we need the rest of the retina? It turns out at night or in the evening, when the lighting is minimal, we see clearer and better objects by the lateral parts of the retina. This fact was noticed by astronomers back in the century before last. Discovered that if you look directly at the constellation, then only bright stars. But if you look to the side as if sideways, then you can distinguish stars or lesser magnitude. So if you need to find path in a dark forest, it's better to look not directly under your feet, but somewhat inside. Then with peripheral vision you can catch what is inaccessible. Direct look, it is clear that we cannot distinguish colors with the lateral cells of the retina. Hence the expression at night all cats are gray. But to navigate in darkness, we can do much better with sticks, peripheral cells. This is necessary to activate both central and peripheral vision. And before laying out the recovery methods, central fixation. I note that in this form and sequence, they're not described anywhere. I collected all the methods bit by bit, analyzing various sources and drawing on wealth of personal and practical experience. Thanks for watching. I hope it will help you to understand how central fixation works. Subscribe to my channel and we'll see you again.